care. Because if, as long as they're here for a month and they're a resident, they're paying taxes, then we should find a way to make their lives better.
Okay, but what, let's say that we're putting this ride thing together, okay? And we say, oh, we've got all this volume, and then all of a sudden, in reality, how come like we're only getting 60% of the people using this at the most? So that's why that's why I put that one in there.
Okay. Anyone else agree with me?
From my minority.
Yeah, I think if you make it too long, they don't have the patience to fill it out.
Really?
Well, you're talking to somebody who's like. That done. So, I mean, you know, it's like, I don't
I'm the worst when it comes to that.
I mean, I'll tell you, I would think people
don't
people
drag it out.
They're retired.
Yeah, I think people would
want
to spend
time. It doesn't matter. I'm retired. I still don't.
Well, you're going to have people who would welcome this and spend time doing it. You're going to have people that don't want you to know any information whatsoever.
I think that's more it, Linda. It's
true.
They just don't want to advertise that.
Right.
Okay. Keep going.
All right. So we keep that one or?
Yeah.
Okay. No, that's all right. You're supposed to play devil's advocate.
Yeah.
Right. That's right. I mean, I want to hear that. Yeah. Access to the internet. Okay. This is important. Right. This is a question I think we've asked before, and we should continue to ask it. Hopefully, it's growing.
You can use the internet.
Right.
Have access to it. What's that? Okay. Do you feel comfortable using your computerized device to make appointments and get information? That's another important thing. Like, oh yeah, I have a phone, but you know, all I do is get pictures from my grandson or something like that. Right. It's unfortunately somewhere like that. People that I know. Okay, now transportation needs. How long do you intend to continue driving?
I write down none of your business. If I was filling out this,
you can just not fill it out. Do you think it's a fair question?
I think it's a fair question, but I don't know.
I think that's a hard question.
I actually like
that's
the question more about.
Very emotional issue.
Yeah, I would just say, do you drive or not?
Yeah.
Okay, do you drive?
Yeah, because the next question is I do not drive because I know that people
are
like, what are you talking about?
That's another bullet point.
Drive forever.
Okay, do you drive or not?
People really don't know. They can't say.
Do you drive, yes or no?
Yeah.
Right.
Then we'll
change that's
that.
A depressing
okay.
question.
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
How long do you drive for?
I love it.
She knew that was coming.
Yeah.
I should have known how to get that.
Oh,
all right, keep going. This is good.
Here we go. Can you drive yourself safely to appointments?
That's kind of rude, too.
What?
This next one?
Can you drive yourself safely to appointments?
I would.
These are real questions that are asked on surveys. This is a real question.
I would put, do you drive yes or no? And then if it's yes, answer the following. So, in other words, you can skip. I mean, because if they don't drive, they're certainly not going to drive safely.
This becomes a sub.
That's good.
Sub,
okay.
Sub.
Like that.
If yes, if
I would
yes.
just say, are you comfortable driving
yes.
to appointments?
Comfortable.
Yeah, I just.
You have almost the same question right under it. I would leave that one, and I would delete the one. Can you drive yourself?
Yes,
to
I would delete
right.
it.
Because you kind of said
right.
the same thing
yes.
twice.
Yes.
All right, done.
I would
okay.
get rid
that's good.
Of that.
I like that.
Okay. Yeah. There is overlap there.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay. Good. So we'll keep the next one. All right. If you do not drive, how are you getting to your medical appointments?
That's a good one.
Yeah, I think it's a fair question, right? If you do not drive, how are you currently shopping for groceries? Fair?
That's good, yeah.
Okay. Do you use the Linfield Senior Center van? No and yes.
I'd love to see how many people are using Peapod and Amazon.
I would hope
that gets more and more. Because it's such a great, I don't use it, but I will when I'm older.
Yeah.
You know, with self-driving cars.
I know some of you use people.
Pretty soon you'll just think of something and it'll show up at your door the next day.
With a drone.
You're almost there.
Buy a drone, yeah. If the town provided a vehicle specifically for transportation to and from medical appointments, would you use it? This was the whole van thing. Can we get a van
yeah.
a special van?
And I think you should follow that up with how often would you need a some people might
would you use it. How often?
Right.
Would you use it and how often?
For a medical appointment, some people might have medical appointments every week year round, and some might have two a year.
Yeah.
You know, so
okay.
I think if everybody says once or twice a year, that might not be worth it to do something.
Good point. That's a good point. So we know how it will be used. Okay.
For ease of tabulation, we
yes.
probably should put, you know, X times per year, you know, give a range so that when we go to tabulate it, it won't be.
Okay. All right. We'll make that change. Excuse me. Would you need assistance getting on and off the van?
That's a good question.
Yeah, I think that's a good one.
We have to be prepared.
Don't ask him.
They say none of your business. It's like, okay, well, you know.
Senior center vans, we do not offer assistance. I mean, we stand at the curb and we'll catch our hand,
right. Yeah.
But we don't lift, we right. don't, you know, heave ho, we don't, yeah. you know, we just, we're not trained to do that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Heave ho.
Heave ho.
Yeah.
Okay.
Would you need assistance getting from the van to your appointment? Well, I mean, walking like from the van into the building, yes.
Right.
Because the ride does this, right?
Right.
They do that. So fair question?
Yes.
Okay. Would you pay a fee of approximately $5 per second?
Or you could ask how much would you be willing to pay and give them choices.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right. They'll pick the lowest amount. That's the problem.
Well,
if you ask how much do you want to pay for X,
if we put a dollar down, people will check a dollar.
Five. Well, you don't put a dollar down.
You can't do it for a dollar.
Five is the lowest amount. $5.75. I mean, something
okay.
like that, give them choices,
right.
see what they say. Maybe they're willing to pay more.
Would they really choose the lowest amount?
Yeah. I would think. How much do you want to pay for something?
I would write on their
list,
if you
too
stop
honest
at happy hour, I'll pay more.
You, I love it.
Okay, I will change that. All right, so we'll have
$10 to get the limo.
dollar amounts.
I'll take the limo, anything.
Okay. Do you have any medical issues that would require a companion to be with you? Mobility, memory impairment, vision.
I would follow that up with, would you provide your own companion or would you need a companion?
Okay.
That's a good way to do it.
And the next question is, can't the companion drive you?
Oh, because he's blind.
Yeah, right. The companion is right. Yeah. If he really walks. Would you anticipate using the van for these medical procedures? And we asked about this specifically because this is an issue where we would have to have a specially trained driver for these kinds of things. Because uh-huh. colonoscopy, okay. you know, you get immersive and so on. Cataract surgery, you've been anesthetized somewhat. Chemotherapy leaves you in bad shape.
The only concern I have on that is that you're going to have information on potentially,
I don't
you know,
think
HIPAA type.
And there's other conditions too.
Okay,
that
they're not putting the name to it, right? And they're not signing.
That's true too.
It's an anonymous.
On the other
it's
hand,
anonymous.
True.
Yeah. Okay,
it's
you're right.
People who haven't had have can't. I mean, if you ask someone who's not had cancer and has not had to have chemotherapy treatments, would you anticipate using the van for these procedures? They're probably not in a good place to answer that. They don't know when they would be. You know. That's my question. Does someone really have the foresight to see whether they would need the van?
If you are being treated for something and they tell you it will be 6 months or 2 years or whatever,
right.
I mean, they generally know how long these things go.
Maybe we could reword it to say something like, the new van service for medical appointments would not be available for people going to or from procedures such as. You know, we'll discuss that way they're kind of not saying what their health issue is.
So, right. So we're excluding people going to and from these procedures.
Yeah,
does this impact you?
Yeah, but I just don't think you're going to want to get into
it. I think you just leave this out.
I think we just leave it out totally then.
I'd leave it out then.
We'll just take it out. Okay. All right, that's out. Okay. Would you be
hard for you? It was hard for you.
Would you be able to wait for your return trip home from your appointment, knowing that the van might not be able to pick you up until 1 to 2 hours after your appointment? This is a big deal because this is why some people complain about the ride. This is one of the big complaints about the ride.
And about our service too.
Yes. Yeah. People don't want to wait. I can tell you, my mother. Blank, yeah. I'd say, what else do you have to do? But she would say to me, no, she said, I just don't like waiting an hour, you know. And she had to bring food with her, you know, she'd bring crackers and things like that to eat because she's like, I get too hungry. I understand why people get upset about it, I completely get it, but we need to know if this is a deal breaker or not. question?
Yep.
Okay. Stupid. All right. Next one. In what towns are your doctors and most frequently visited medical facilities located? And I gave a list. And this would be a, like checkboxes, because it might be more than one. All right. Then the option of list any that we didn't make up. Because we need to know what our service area is going to be.
So you should say something like, you can check more than one or something.
Oh, I will do that. It'll be checkboxes, yes.
Check as many as apply.
Check as many as apply, yes. Okay, ride services. Have you ever used the Gliss medical ride? Yes or no, and if, you know, if, yes, if no, why not? Because it's a good deal. Have you ever used the MBTA ride? Okay, and again, same thing. If not, why not? If you qualify for long and so on. I think this is valuable information. Okay. All right. General health. This is where we get into this. I'm afraid of this one now. Okay, do you have any of the following? Should we ask this?
Oh.
Should we ask this?
Well, they have memory issues. They can't
ask Pam and see what she says.
Pam, please comment. Please comment on this.
No, I don't know that that's, kind of a,
what relevance is this?
Yeah, it's a touchy area, and it's not really relevant.
Where's it going?
Yeah.
I think to know, like, the types of folks that,
they have memory issues, they can't remember that anymore.
This is not necessarily for the transportation.
Right.
It's more to understand what is the community dealing with.
Right.
Rather than the
itself, really is the community. Right. It's taking the temperature of the community.
Right.
That's what this question is about.
So maybe are you concerned about any of these following
issues?
Right. Maybe something like that.
Maybe add to the
that's going to work.
I waved the way
yeah,
I asked.
Concerned about
yeah.
Well, I wouldn't word it that way, because we're all concerned, right? Even though you might not have depression, that who's not concerned about it?
Maybe are you concerned about it affecting you in the future? I don't know.
I don't like that whole thing.
Okay.
A little bit interesting.
People can be put off by that.
Say that again, Henry.
People can be really put off by that.
I mean, either that or everybody.
I mean, if they're already depressed, they're going to be more depressed when they see.
You get 100%.
I usually have it all by
anonymous.
I mean, will say, I wish they just asked me if I was lonely. But I really.
People who are lonely want
a solution
to be able
for loneliness.
You know what? Yeah. I
don't have any solution for loneliness.
Well, I think the senior center. That's probably. Yeah.
Yeah.
Outreach and bring
I mean, you know, it's like
a big solution.
Yeah, I think the senior center is a big solution.
Yes, but people who are lonely and depressed don't necessarily come.
Yeah, I would table this, however, this question. But the only thing is that this next question is what I like.
Okay, so we're gonna.
That's my thought.
Do we want to just cross this out, this whole thing?
Yes.
The whole thing, is everybody?
Yes.
No, not the whole thing, just that. Do you have anything to follow?
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, how
but
about,
I think
how about the
thing,
second part of it?
In order for
remain?
Me, that's an, I like,
okay.
This is important, but I think
right.
Instead of describing,
mm-hmm.
Are there boxes and things that they can check? Meaning,
okay.
You know, what do they need?
Because
they,
how do they know what they're going to need?
I agree. That's
the
problem. You don't know if you're going to.
If they're perfectly healthy right now, how do they know what they're going to need?
Right.
Well, but I
maybe if you said in the next year or two, but if you leave it too open-ended,
yeah.
I mean.
Well, then maybe, is it, what are you concerned with as you're, you know, because I know.
Transportation, food, socialization.
Yeah.
Money.
Yeah.
I'm afraid of running out of money. This is exact, you know, I mean, I don't think people are that dumb. I really don't. I mean, you know what you, maybe I plan better than
well,
most
see,
folks.
I don't think
you know,
it's a question of being dumb. It's human nature, not things that are going to happen to us. Illness, death, and death.
I think you're right. Aging, illness, and death
are things that we as human beings do not want to accept. And do not want to think.
Well, that's the number one reason why people don't come to a senior center,
that's
because
right.
I'm not going to a senior center.
Because it'll remind me of what I'm going to look like.
My 87-year-old mother says that exactly.
They, you know, I'm not going to a cheap one. And
very good lunches.
Believe me, for the 30 years I sold long-term care insurance, I know this. Talking to all those people,
I do
didn't
agree.
Want
I
to
do
accept
agree
illness, right, aging, and death.
Right.
But I think so. You were confronting people with the very issues you tell yourself.
But I mean, I was trying to sell them.
She asked all these questions.
She asked all these questions. What did you get when you asked about the
motive? No, but I'll tell you.
Usually I sail because I was very good.
Yeah. But I know. Go ahead, Gene.
Maybe you could add the word might. Describe the assistance you might need.
Yeah.
In the years.
Yeah. No, I agree. Because I think
that
there's because I think there's things like, because I know if you talk to my mother, her thing is going to be, she's like, yeah, I get lonely on Sundays, and I know I'm going to need help with food shopping. And she knows these things.
Cleaning the house. Right?
Those are the things that I think.
I want to ride to church or something.
Yeah, exactly. I can't drive at night, and I want to go somewhere.
Exactly. I will say this. The open-ended question is good in terms of getting broad responses. They're bad in terms of compiling it into a usable condensed form.
That's why I think if you could put maybe 10 different things, you know, 5 and 5
also
on the side. Just think, you know,
okay. You could have another.
You need another. Like, you know, I'm worried about money. I'm worried about managing groceries. I'm worried about falling. Those kinds of things.
What I don't see on here is the question which I'm coming from, a place where I taught healthcare living in the Cleveland Clinic for years in Nevada to caregivers and people with chronic conditions. I don't see a question on here if you're directing to seniors that says, are you a caregiver?
Oh, that's a good one.
Would you like support? Would you like to see support? I mean,
that's really an important issue.
And that's really why I came that night to the meeting to get on this committee, because they think it's so important to having been and also having health issues. That are you a caregiver is a really important question.
Because there's a lot of folks out there suffering.
And then we could do something about a caregiving program.
Well, we have one here. We have a caregiver support group here.
But
we actually
just more of a support group is a health and living kind of class where you learn lot of different ways in which to help yourself.
That's what this group does. Greater Lynn Senior Services runs it for us. And it's excellent.
Oh, it's not about caring, it's more for taking care of you
taking
as a person.
Care, yeah.
Oh, that's,
well, right. She
that's
calls
great.
Both.
But
and actually, the dementia
workshop we had all
day workshop. My mom couldn't use that. Yours really probably didn't know about it because she didn't probably need to pay for it. Right. That's
great. This is for caregivers.
No, I know. No, she was taking care of my dad. Yeah.
We did a free luncheon, free manicures, free everything. We told all caregivers to come in treat you, all day. It was wonderful.
Okay, then under the senior center, do you participate in any of the programs or services provided at the Northfield Senior Center? Yes. What activities or services would you like to have?
So do you guys have any that you might think
could
list, or do you think that should Bob leave it open-ended?
Right.
Or like,
get a few open-ended questions if possible.
Yeah.
You could pick a wall in there.
Pickleball? If you could invite. Well, you know your own attendance for activities, so to some degree, you know that already. We're asking questions we actually have much better data for. Already, like attendance records.
I can get Linda up over email or something. And then finally, in your own words, right, do you have any additional remarks about living in Linfield as a senior that you'd like to share? This is kind of part of the first question. And that just is pros.
This is good. We only killed one question.
Yeah,
we started off like we're going to kill them all.
Yeah.
and then we backed off.
Well,
and I think we just have to, you know, I think that is a good point that Pam brings up that, you know, we just have to be sure that we have enough questions or we present it in a way that doesn't make it so it's too cumbersome to go through. So maybe we can double-sided and, you know, we probably want to make it. So just,
and
I think these are all valuable.
Too. Yeah. We put it in line, so Survey Monkey.
Yeah. Right. And then the big question is how do we targeted to the seniors. Like, I think the question here that we brought up was that if it goes into tax bill is going to get everybody. Right? And is that, how valuable is that? And then does that skew our numbers? Or do you nicely say, do not complete this unless you're over 60 something years or whatever age you put up?
That's what you have.
Or you could put under 55, and if they check that, then you just throw those away.
That's right. Bingo, do that.
Why you
are
nailed
star today. You are killing it today.
I love it.
Yeah, that's perfect. And then, so timing of this.
Interesting to see.
When can we, you know, when is the next tax bill that goes? When is the next one that goes up?
We just had one. So it'll be August.
No.
Okay.
June. Oh, okay. June tax bill. They would stuff that. They would want to have stuff ready a month.
Okay, to check.
Oh yeah, we haven't had that. It comes out in May.
Right. Like,
so that would be fairly.
Yeah. I'll check with town treasurer to see who's scheduled already, because the one thing is you can't make it go the way.
Can't double.
Right. If you do too many, then the year costs.
This is going to go way over. And if you condense it down too much, I think it's a turnoff. If it's too tight,
yeah.
But not enough white space, they're going to be like, oh, this is very easy. This makes me want to fill this out the way you
want. It's too big, though.
Well, it's too big for mailing.
And it's
got to
be on both sides of the paper.
It's not good for mailing.
No.
The master plan survey was very long. 900 people.
Wow.
Yeah. People
knew.
But you're right about the tax bill. The problem is they'll probably put you over the weight. The question is, can we get from the town clerk if we decide to mail it, which we have to find the money for, you'd have to get the household with someone age 55 and over. And is 55 where you want to start? Because that's probably half the households that live there probably have someone 55 or older, right?
Yeah. It's
a significant expense.
Those younger households will know this isn't for them, because they're in the age group in the second question. They go, oh, it's not for me. It's not to 55.
Yeah, you can put the things as, you know, you stop here.
Yeah, stop here.
Yeah.
That's right.
You know, so how do we do that? How do we get it back?
I'm thinking now that it's probably going to be too long to be in the text.
Okay.
It's on the survey. The plan was online.
And
you could pick it up at Town Hall and Library. But
and they did a good job. They did a good job advertising it to everybody.
Right.
But we first need to find out if we can designate.
The other thing we have to put in right up front is, do you live in Linfield? Because if you don't live in Linfield, if you put in the senior center, for example, there are a number of people who don't live in Linfield, so probably.
For Linfield residents only.
Right.
So
that's true.
Let's write that question. So, how do we disseminate this? Can't do text. Online's not really the
option. Give it to some of the churches.
But have it at town hall. You can spread it everywhere.
Town hall. Have it
but it's
seniors.
Very hard to work.
Have it doctor's offices.
You're not tagging everybody, you're tagging
them. Yeah.
Truly, let's say, I can tell you, who's 55 and over?
It's still going to be considerable expense, because you're not picking back on anything else. So you're getting postage.
Is that what we consider senior?
Actually, I think for Medicare, 60.
Your door says 60.
Yeah, the door
our
says
center
60.
Is 60.
Yeah.
A lot 60. Of centers are 60. There are still a few that are 55.
Okay.
You want to do 60?
Well, the residential housing.
Want to do 60 and over?
60 and over, yes.
Right.
65. Are there 60 over 60? So, how expensive would it like bulk rate
I don't even want to guess it, because the bulk rate, you know, do we have a municipal rate separate from first class? That's something we don't. I'd have to talk to someone.
Do we think mailings are necessary? Now, again, you're nodding yes.
I think they're
too. Yeah. Okay.
I mean, if you're going to want to
read. What I was thinking, yeah, I guess
You have to have them. I mean, that would require people either drop it someplace or
yes.
mail it back.
Like, mail it back. See,
we're not doing.
We can't do.
No, we can't do postage page envelopes.
Find out what Judy has to say first.
Yeah, I'll advise
Judy.
So can you follow up?
Yeah.
Just make sure we can figure out. I'd love to be able to come back to the next meeting.
Yeah.
And have a definitive plan of kind of how we're going to get this out. Yeah. But I think this is great. I think these are good questions.
Yeah.
And I think I'll be curious to see what it comes back. So.
Yeah, not only the postage, but the
yeah, the printing.
So
yes,
I do the senior center mailing,
yeah.
the annual appeal, and that's around 2,300. For the postage, every household.
Every house gets it? $2,000?
Is that first class mail or bulk?
Bulk. It's bulk. And I use a mailing house, you know, does the printing.
Okay. Oh, that includes.
That doesn't include that.
That's just the mailing, $2,300?
Just the mailing. That's just the price. But that's a lot, that's every household.
Yeah. I've done bulk mailings around $4,000.
My
guess is just to give you perspective, that is far bigger than the office supply budget for almost every office in town hall. I mean,
okay.
You can't say, hey, Bob, can you pick that up? Not if I want to buy a pen.
Yeah.
It's that's
why stuffing
it
in the envelope
like,
is a good idea.
Yes, it is.
It's already going.
Right. It's the size of it. That's the problem, unless you really want
maybe
to.
Maybe we could do one page. For each month's water
bill. Water bills go with the tax bill.
Well, the next question might be to Christine O'Sullivan is how many pages can we put in the tax bill? It'd still be underweight. Two, three.
That's a great question.
Then you know how much you have to consolidate it down to. You know, if you want to do it that way.
Yeah. Start that way. Okay. Let's go find
the cheapest
way. So Trudy wouldn't she be able to spit out labels?
That's what Bob's trying to find out.
I'll find out. She gets to put out labels.
Yeah. They don't have ages.
Because
So any questions on the survey that we got? But this is great, Bob. Thank you so much for doing this. This is real helpful. And it'll be great to get the information back. Any other comments?
Revise.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
Hey, I'll talk to Trudy.
Great. A couple. So the recreation committee. Rich sent me a real quick note. I don't know if you want to expand, but there's more bowling coming. I hear.
Yes, there's more bowling coming May 16th, I believe.
Yep.
That's great. The first round was huge.
I love the pictures. The paper.
It's so much fun. And everybody really interacted. Seniors interacted with the kids. Kids were fabulous. So everybody's really excited to go again. So we're going to do that. And then they're going to try to set up a mini golf, too, at some point in the summer. Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
What age group kids were involved?
It was all elementary through middle school, I would say. Yeah. It was a wide variety of ages. And a lot of boys, too.
You went, right?
Yeah. My grandson.
Good.
All right.
Good. Anything else on record?
If we're promoting things like the activities with the senior side, be able to sit at the desk and Eric, the cable guy, you know Eric, right?
Yeah.
Our cable person, to come over and shoot some activity here so that we could run it on the cable station and maybe promote.
We have not asked him in a while, but I can certainly do that.
The seniors watch that.
The guy who was here before Eric did a really great video of the senior center. You know, he went through the building and did, you know, people in the hair salon and that type of thing. He did the band service and all, but it's never run. I mean, that's even, I can see if Eric still has it.
That was before we had the Merit Center. So our equipment is significantly upgraded. The editing capabilities we have now, back then, we were in basically a closet in the high school, and it wasn't temperature controlled, so you would imagine what that would do to sensitive electronics stuff. So, yeah, I mean, he'd probably want to start from scratch, because because he can now, he has better equipment and certainly better editing equipment.
They're,
they're
always looking for content to put on
You know, I'm in a quandary over advertising because so many of our programs are filled with waiting lists that we don't even advertise a lot of things now anymore because people come
to us.
Yeah, I don't want to turn people away. And we have a waiting list for, you know, just about everything. I mean, even our Zumba class last week, they want us to now open this wall. She had like 55 to 60 people in there, and they were coming out and saying, we can't move. It's everything, you know, the meals and the trips, have every trip has a waiting list. And,
why are so popular? You bringing that instructor from Kenny Buckport?
We have really good instructors here, I have to say. We've been very fortunate. They've been here for many years. Huge following. I got it. None of that going on.
Okay.
But yeah, we do. I mean, we have a couple days a month now where we break 300 people.
Wow.
We're always at around 200. Like last Tuesday, we had 326. We have a lot of good instructors.
So you're like myopia. You don't have to take out ads.
Yeah, right.
You know, it's hard, and I'm very frustrated with people. People are disappointed, and we feel bad about it. Then we try to schedule more, and you know, show something a different time, do something a second time. But that just doesn't always work. So.
All right, so. Anything else that anybody wanted to bring up? That's on the agenda. So I want to thank everybody for coming today. I know we've had a little bit of a dip in attendance. I don't know how I'm going to fix that. But we'll resume. I think we've got some good takeaways. You will look forward to getting your penmanship and everything written down on what our next steps are. But I do want to thank everybody. I know that we missed a little time with March. I'm hoping to get us back on track. You know, we've got some follow-ups on the property tax relief that I'll follow up on. A couple areas. One is to talk to the Housing Authority. The other one is to start looking at the some of the legislation, maybe how we can broaden it so that it hits more people. And I'll also reach out to Brad Jones to see what else they have going on. Potentially another. Survey, so great job on that. That was good to see this. And we'll figure out the right way to kind of get this disseminated out. And keep cranking along on what you guys are doing. This is great. I love that cross recreation senior center. You know, I think I love seeing the younger people interacting, you know, with the seniors.
The other thing we're doing too is we're taking busloads of seniors over to the high school new makerspace.
Oh, yes.
And that is. Phenomenal. Those kids.
That was fun.
I am so impressed with the kids at that high school. Yeah, they are amazing. I mean, so kind, so welcoming, so patient. We're going to be on our third trip over.
That's great. That's so good for the students.
It is.
You know?
They have a new makerspace with all kinds of equipment. And actually, our Italian class is going to be going over to learn some things. We had the last session was on, everybody took their iPads. Phones and kids work one-on-one with them. And now our art class wants to go to see what they can, how they can incorporate some of their new equipment into their art class.
What I don't, I'm not trying to create programming for you, but I think what's really important, we try and do it with our kids, is I think that students and younger people don't always think that they can learn from seniors. They just think that. And there's got to be a way, because it took me a while when I was older, and I'm like, I don't think they know more than I do, and I can learn from that. But I think it'd be good to somehow find a way for this the students at the high school level to somehow have an experience where the seniors are teaching them something that they don't know anything. They don't know. They walk out and wow, that's, I don't know how to do that, but that's something I think it makes the seniors feel good. But I think it's good for the students too. The students walk out a lot. I have newfound respect for the seniors.
It's just like with the board of directors that we have here. I take so many. Agenda items into them because I value their opinions. There's things that I really don't necessarily need board input on, but I always just like to pick their brains because they've been there and done it, and
yeah.
they always give me the best advice.
Yeah, I know, and I think it's lost on a lot.
It is.
A lot of people. And so there's a way to somehow, I think it makes the seniors feel good, but we need more of an education for the kids to, you know, see something like that. So. Well, history. I mean, I have my daughter watching Band of Brothers, and I'm like, look at these, what these folks have done. You can learn from, you know, what their stories are all about. Anyways, sorry, getting off track. We don't have a quorum, so I'm not going to ask for a motion to close the meeting. So we are going to adjourn the meeting. And I want to thank you guys all so much for coming, and we'll do this again in May. This is April, so May, whatever the third Wednesday is.
Are you taking the summer off?
No.
No,
I want to keep pushing until we can get, I want to get the survey through, I want to get some.
Let's work the summer and take the winter off.
Yeah, there you go. But thank you all so much.
I keep coming back out here in the dark.
I know.
We're cold. Oh
my God. That's right. It's not dark now.
It's so nice.
We have a date for me.
Oh, yeah. You know, we usually do the third, right? The third Wednesday. That's correct. It's just
the
third
the
Wednesday.
16th.
So the 16th. It's
not a specific time.
Permanent. I don't know if it's, I don't think it's permanent.
It's in another region. It's not specifically an ad hoc group to get one thing done and then.
You didn't have a goal.
Nope.
An end goal.
Right.
Constant advisory committee.
Yeah. Because
it could be multiple.
So May 16th at 5:30. Great. Thank you all so much. Enjoy.